Bank opens 11:30 drawer. 9:30 again. He grunted. Changed out of his blue shirt. He wanted to be ready. Hank sighed at the belief of the 29th lamp being lit and thought about his job. Sheesh, I can't stop thinking about my job. My truest passion. He checked his watch. 9:33. It's the only place I feel understood. My clients really speak my language. He got up to go back to dinner and hit his head on the ceiling, which was really too low for any human being. Life is pretty good. I like my job. I go to work. I go home. I feel satisfied. He sat down at the table with the empty plate and some thermometers and stethoscopes he stole from work to comfort him. He really didn't like being home. He was really enjoying his meal when he found a cat hair on his blue shirt. He held his breath. He sprinted out the front door and ripped off his shirt and looked at me. Gone. So were the ashes. There was another package at the door. I didn't think they could do it, but they really found me. They really did it. It was 9:45. He was sitting at the empty dinner plate after the cat had eaten the ashes of his wages. Took a bite of his empty dinner plate and swallowed hard. He knew he'd have to look soon. If he didn't look, it would never go away. He stiffened his neck, trying to keep his whole body still, as he could feel the thing outside the window staring. He could feel that he had to hit him like a laser point of the sniper rifle right between the eyes. He smiled. 2 more minutes went by. Hank steadily staring at the point. Holding his gaze so he wouldn't look at the thing out of his window. And then the 29th lamp went out. Hank started to panic. But there was no 29 lights, and there was no certainty in the universe. He started losing his mind, stuck to that. His thoughts. His shaking eyes wandered up and out the window. His gaze flew out the window with a jolt and found the thing that came each night at 9:45 to stare at him. It was himself. He didn't understand, although he never questioned it. Hank always came to his window at 9:45 to stare at himself, and it almost always surprised him. He stared back and no longer had control. He couldn't look at or do anything besides stare at himself. With aching urgency and 3 drops of sweat, Hank wanted more than anything just to leave his body. He wanted to go to work, be with the animals, even the gang of cats which ate his blue shirt. He had nothing to say. He thought, you should really have something to say if ever you are faced with yourself. Still, Hank could not move nor think. Hank just stared at himself. And Hank stared back. The Hank outside the window suddenly spoke. I want to go home now. Still, Hank couldn't move. He knocked on the window, saying, please, I want to go home. Another lamp went out. 28 was bearable, but 27 was much too troublesome. morning thought, maybe tomorrow I'll let him in. And then he would forget again, like he did every day. But Hank didn't forget. It was 9:45 the next night, and the guilt he felt at the pleading eyes of himself the night before made him ready. He looked up right away. This time Hank did not come to the window. Hank worried. He thought of his job to comfort himself. It didn't seem to matter. He turned all his lights off and then on again. He felt nothing. He stared at the white walls. Nothing seemed to comfort him. He just wanted Hank to come back. Where the hell could I be?